name was Stormy Warren.
This is the highway.
The highway.
Oh, we're actually going to get delayed.
I think so.
We lucked out, didn't
yeah.
we?
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. I'm shocked.
Set up and everything. I said, I bet the ferry just come in.
Yeah, I thought maybe we'd miss the ferry. For those of you that are listening, we're getting ready to cross the Jamestown Ferry. Well, it's still.
We're going to be on the inside.
Lately that's all we get is the inside. You wouldn't think there would be such a balancing effort here, but there. All right, yep, we're on the inside. We have crossed this ferry several times on this trip. Don't get me up against the wall. One time, Butch.
Fire extinguisher.
Yeah. Okay, folks. Here's something else that's like one of my favorite things to do when we're traveling. And I don't know, you probably can tell already. People that have been on these already know what this is. I love ferry rides. Okay. Look what we got. Isn't it great? We got our flag flying. Got lots of cars back there. We thought we were gonna get in an outside lane this time. Lately, all we do is get in the inside lane. I hate those. But there's just something about a ferry ride that takes me back to my childhood. If you ever get a chance to ride one and you haven't done so, do so. You'll like it. Make this crossing every day, 7 days a week. Takes 15 minutes to make it. The ferry carries over 1 million vehicles every year. They're trying to get a bridge here. I should say a politician tried to get a bridge here. And he tried for years, but the people did not want a bridge. They wanted to keep the integrity of the historic part of the ferry and the crossing. And it really does make it a lot nicer than having a bridge. We're at the Lower Surrey Church, Lawns Creek Parish. It was built in 1639 and it burned in 1868. Is on the National Historic List. So this is older than our country is. This is a relatively new headstone. Charles William Sutton was born in 1842 and died in 1880. There's a lot of other headstones out here that are a lot older, but typical with the age, you can't read the you can read some of the dates, but not all of them. But this is a very, very nice headstone. According to local folklore, going back more than a century, the ruins of the old brick church are said to be haunted. Many credible people, young and old, over several generations claim to have seen the flying fireball. Those who have seen it describe it as simply a fireball. It rises from the church cemetery into the air about 40 feet and slowly drifts across the broad fields towards Bacon's Castle. A former owner of the plantation saw the fireball out of his window and rushed outside thinking his barn was on fire. Another person staying at the 17th century mansion woke up to find the ball circling his bed before flying back out the window. And many years ago, a church meeting was being held in the graveyard, and everyone that was in attendance claimed to have seen the ball on fire. So, one thing about it, this area tends to have a bit of paranormal activity. Hey, we find ourselves now on the Chip Oaks Plantation. It's actually a state park now. It was deeded over to the state. And this is the oldest continuously farmed plantation in the United States. It has 1,400 acres. It looks to the east onto the James River. So that way they could get all of their products to market. They had access to the river. They had slave quarters. They had management quarters, which actually now some people that work the farm live. And then the slaves, they also have the slave quarters. And they've been turned into cabins that you can rent. These are, a few of these houses are the ones that the overseers, or what we would consider the managers, would be living in. The slave quarters are over on another section of the farm, and they're a one-story, but these are a two-story. We were going to a castle, and in a sense this is a castle. This is considered called Bacon's Castle, but it's not the actual name of the house. It's a plantation house. There was an uprising, and the gentleman who led the uprising, actually he didn't have anything to do with taking the house, but some of his troops did, and they actually lived in the house. So it became known as Bacon's Castle, and the name stuck, and it will probably always be referred to as Bacon's Castle. Now, if you want to stay here, some folks might have a problem, because there's quite a bit of paranormal activity, such as heads floating around, furniture has been moved, fireballs. No area of the property is exempt from the hauntings. Inside the mansion, there's been issues. There's voices telling people to get out. out on the grounds. Gunshots echo through an otherwise silent room. So it's a case of, do you dare to spend the night in Bacon's Castle? Hi y'all, we'd love it if you joined us on our travels. Hit the subscribe button and the like button. And even if you didn't like this, subscribe anyway, because you never know where our journey will take us.